Hey, good morning. From Kashabowie River Resort in Ontario, Superior Country. We're gonna be fishing for smallmouth bass today, topwater. Look how calm this is, man. Deadly, this is the kind of stuff I was born to fish with. And it's early season up here, you can catch and release. And the beauty of this little trip here to this resort is walleye opens tomorrow. Right behind me here, below the fast water of the rapids, the anticipation to fish this area, guys have been waiting all year, and I'm here one day before, smash some bass before I go and catch walleyes. So sit back and relax, think about Superior Country, and this place right here, Kashabowie, perfect setup, in God's country, what else could you ask for? Hopefully you're inspired when you see the kind of bass that there's here, how we're catching them, releasing them, kissing them, you name it. Because it's about to happen this week on Extreme Angler TV from Superior Country. Let's go do it. Here we are, first spot. Carl and Kyle looking for smallmouth bass with topwaters. Is it getting better? Look how calm it is. Looks like glass, man. We're in a bay here that's 2 feet to 6 feet, lots of rock, lots of opportunity, and lots of bass. So sit back, have some fun, because this river system is going to inspire you, because it's got me jumping like a hound on a hunt. I mean, woof. I can't wait to catch some fish.
Attaboy.
There's one there.
Yep.
Nice. Ooh, chunky little fish too, eh?
Yeah, they're happy.
Oh, there's another one grabbed it. I think I got two, dude. You said that.
That's funny.
I think I got two. I kid you not. Yes, look. Hey,
no
I
way.
Do.
That's look. Hilarious.
Look at that. Look.
They hungry.
Oh, he came off.
The other guy dropped it.
Yeah, the other one came off. There was two fish there. I'm going to buy a lottery ticket. He's a good luck charm. There was two.
That's
buddy,
funny.
You
yeah,
saw
he
that?
Came, yeah, he chased it.
Yep. I saw him sideways just hanging on to it.
Yeah, scrappies. I want that.
Look at that, eh?
That's beautiful.
What a way to start. Oh, look at that. I had two. Now I got none.
Unreal.
Think about that, man. Wow. Kyle was saying, you ever get two fish? Like I said, sometimes on a walking
well,
bait.
Well, normally that's like
I fluked
my
it.
Son has done it, but on a big, like a three hook spook, like a big whatever.
So, little bait. These fish have big attitude. You see that? That's where I'm going to start right here. Kashabowie River Resort. Almost got two, but they popped off, but I don't care. I'm here having fun. Let's re-rig and see if we can get another one. Right there.
Oh, you.
Hey?
Yeah.
Guess what's there, right? Yeah. Oh, nice bite too. Nice bite. Oh, that's why.
Northern
gator.
He's a northern. That's why he came back.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
I think that's a smallmouth.
Yeah. He got double duty here. Fish on every line. Good thing there wasn't eight guys in the boat. Everyone's got fish. Just a chunker. Oh, a nice color here. Nice looking fish. Look at that. Look who's got that too.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
If he comes off, he comes off, but I'm good. I'll get him close. And
nice fish.
Let's see where you are, bass. Hey, there's my first bass, right there. I did have two on, one lure, but chunky fish, beautiful fish. Let's let him go. Go on, bass. Okay, so fish are situated on the shoreline, on some of these rocks and stuff. And again, it's like glass calm. But sometimes first thing in the morning, the popper worked too aggressively, doesn't work. So the more times that we saw, as well as Kyle, leaving that little popper after making some noise, we got bit. I tried the walking bait for a while, a bait that produces fish everywhere I go that just didn't want to chase. So think about that when you go away. Have some different options, okay? Bring a few walking baits, some that make noise and stuff, prop baits. But the popper, you never miss with smallmouth, depending on the cadence and the mood of the fish. That's pretty good, eh? We're catching all kinds of smallmouth everywhere and no fish on beds yet. Pre-spawn still, they don't realize that the water temperatures are perfect now. Went from 2 weeks ago in the 40s to the low 60s. They're gonna get ready, but they're not on yet. So my trusty tube jig snapped along those shoreline edges. There we go.
Nice.
Right off that dark edge on the tube.
Very nice.
A different color in these ones, eh? They're all brown compared to the ones we caught this morning. Rock-dwelling smallmouth with a fat belly. Chunker. Wonder. So we're not fishing in real shallow little bars and stuff and sandbars and pebble rock and stuff that you traditionally have smallmouth spawning on. They're still on those little bit of a breaks where 5-10 feet from shore, it goes from 2 feet to 5-6. Pick up the tube, start catching some fish. There he is. Still close to shore too, eh?
Yeah.
Smallmouth maybe, huh?
I think so.
He was uptight. No. Oh, you. Gator.
I'm good at catching these guys. The way he hit it, I thought it was.
Yeah, I know, me too. Toy, the tube catches everything. Walleye, northern, smallmouth, you name it. You never go wrong with the little micro tube. Early season, mid-season, pressured waterways, and even virgin waterways like this, where they're potentially in some of the bays have never seen an angler yet this year. Pick up the tube, you'll catch them in your northern adventure.
There's a nice bass. There. That's a tank.
Let's see if we can get this one.
That's a tank. That's a big one.
Maybe we'll net this one, eh?
That's a nice fish. One, yeah, I'll grab the net. That is a...
Okay, here he is. Whoop. Oh, no. Okay, there he is.
That's a big, that's a nice smallmouth. Look at that guy.
It's a nice fish.
Yeah.
Cool. Take some pictures, let him go. So far, so good. Popper's been catching fish, the tube jig catching everything from walleye, smallmouth, and pike. But the sun's beating down, my stomach's screaming for lunch. That's the beauty of going to a resort. You have that option of having lunch, a nap, and come back out later on. But can't beat it. Having some fun, seeing the fish roll on the popper, catching them on the tube jig. This could be your place, because it definitely inspired me to come here and have fun like you will if you come here too. That's might be northern. That's the way it's coming in like that. It is too, you little bugger, eh?
The northern bee.
Yeah. No, oh, trout.
Nice walleye.
Walleye or trout?
I think that's a nice walleye.
Yeah, walleye. Look at that.
Look at that. That's weird.
Yeah. Walter on the edge here, eh?
That's a nice fish. Pretty.
On the tube, huh? Yeah, on those breaks, hey? Eh?
Fish like them.
Nice, beautiful walleye.
Yeah, that's a beauty fish. Healthy.
Ready, walleye? Huh? We'll let you go, boy. Ready? Go on. I thought it was a little northern. Right on the taper.
No, I seen the flash of white. I'm like, yeah. I think that's a nice walleye.
All right, it's walleye morning from Kashabowie River Resort. And they say the walleye season just opened here last night at 12:01. It's a sanctuary until June 1st. Today's June 1st. So they say even before our friendly guide, Kyle, comes down, co-owner of the lodge, you could probably catch him off the dock. So I pick up a tube jig. Who knows? I haven't casted here ever. Maybe I'll catch one. Maybe I won't. We'll be fishing fast water like this here, or actually current breaks. He's got 2-3 other spots on the river system, very similar to this. Backwater eddies, rapids, things that walleyes like, especially on slick, calm, hot days. So we're gonna try to just have some fun today, inspire you to think about this resort, this area, Superior Country, for beautiful walleyes and smallmouth bass. Nice.
It's a good one.
Is it?
Yeah, it might be a smallmouth actually.
Really?
Or a northern.
There's another one, smaller one. Oh, good scrap. Oh, I got a northern too. The northern day. Do you see yours yet?
Yep.
What's yours?
A northern.
Mine too. Look, we're at Northern Lodge up in Northern Ontario. Oh, look at, no, he grabbed the walleye, dude.
Yeah.
He grabbed the smallmouth. Look at that. Oh, my poor little guy. Look at that.
Poor guy.
Look at the tail of that. See that northern pike I just had on? He finally let it go, and that's what he had. Look at that, eh? He's all lively. You're a real lucky little bass. Hopefully he grows to like world record size, because all those little scars right there, a fresh pike just had him in his mouth. Poor little guy. Ready? Go on, go live your life. Stay away from the pike. That was nuts. You see that? It was a big size pike too.
That's gonna happen probably a few times. They grab the walleye, little walleye, all the time in the bay.
Wow.
Well, the bay's full of small walleye and big pike.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Yeah, that's a nice fish.
Need some pliers?
He's thick.
Oh yeah, that's a big fish. Oh, that's a better fish. I wonder if this happened again. I think I got a better, another pike. Oh, the pike are around here this morning. Yes, yes, yes. That's a baby pike. Kyle's can eat mine.
Come on, buddy. Come on.
He's got to be tired.
Yeah.
Wow, can you believe the size of the northerns here and how aggressive? First big fish, big, thick, fat back pike. And what does it do? It grabs a smallmouth that I have, holds onto it for a while. I think I've got him by the jig. And he finally decides to spit out that smallmouth. You see all the scars on that fish? Incredible fishing with a big northern sitting in the same areas, gorging on the buffet of walleye and bass. What does it feel like? Good?
Yeah, this is a better fish.
You let me know if you need net.
I think this is a nice walleye.
Is it?
I think so. Just the nice head shakes. I don't think it's a northern. Yeah, nice walleye.
Lifter, that's good fish.
Yeah, that's a keeper.
Put a few inside the box. What do you think, Kyle?
Yeah, if you guys, like I said, if you guys want to have a...
I need to take some pictures of some fish too.
Okay.
We'll just call. Are you allowed to call or here, or you have to keep it?
No, you can call.
Okay. So Kyle, this is actually a river system, right?
Well, it's Shabandawan Lake, but it is... The main inflows Kashabowie River, and then up the lake there's Greenwater Lake flows in as well, and they all flows out the bottom and Shabandawan River. So it is basically a wide river.
But how long is it?
About 30 miles. 30 miles end to end, three basins, upper, middle, and lower, and you can navigate all three. There's narrows between each, but you can navigate. You don't have to portage.
There's a fish. Not bad. Not bad at all. If it's a walleye, it's pretty good. Let's see. I think it is too. Doing the walleye head shakes.
Nice.
Oh, just playing koi.
Yeah.
In deeper water, eh? Those are the ones that are almost eaters, eh?
The almost next
year. The almost, right there. 14 inch maybe, 13?
Yeah.
All right, buddy.
If you were starving, probably that would go in the frying pan.
Thing is, you never starve in this area.
No.
Right?
No.
You never would.
No.
Live off the land here. Walters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this is perfect because it's a good way to learn how to fish without even jumping in a boat when you can.
Of course.
And you know there's a chance of, you're not just casting hopelessly. There's a very good chance you're going to catch fish.
Right. Nice.
Yeah, it works so well.
But Tracy does that, huh?
Yeah, she's the, for Superior Country, because that's how they break it up. Superior, Algoma.
Yes.
She's the ambassador is what she is for Superior Country.
Samson.
There's one.
It's going to take long, eh?
That might be it.
That's the day we're done.
That might be it.
I put a leech on for no reason.
If it's a walleye, it's decent.
Oh, it's going to be a walleye.
Yep.
Look at that.
And we're done. That's a one cast. We're just kidding. There's more here. Carl found the mother load. We're only going to fish till 1 a.m. Look at that skin hooked. I want to show you something. Look at that. Look at that. You talk about skin hooked. That's what happens when you pull too hard. But I wanted four. We'll stay a little bit longer, but those are the size right there. Superior Country. Kashabowie River Resort. Lots of fun, boy. Don't have to go far to catch walleyes here. That is awesome. Go on there.
I'm Tracy Vesho. My husband Kyle and I own Kashabowie River Resort, which is located on Highway 11 on Shibanduan Lake. Some of the best fishing in northwestern Ontario is right off our docks June 1st. You are welcome to bring your own boat or rent one of ours. We do offer an American plan if you're interested in having meals cooked for you. We do have 8 cabins that we rent out that will accommodate from 2 to 12 people. And we look forward to hosting you and your fishing buddies or your family. Our season operates from May long weekend to October 1st. Our bay is a sanctuary. We have a sheltered bay, which is a sanctuary where the walleye spawn. Beginning June 1st when it opens, you're able to fish right off our docks, catch a limit of walleye in minutes. We also have boats available for rent. We have 16-foot Luns with 40-horse Yamahas and 14-foot deep Luns with 20 horsepower if you're willing to go out on the lake. When you're planning your next vacation, please consider Kashabowie River Resort. We've got great fishing, great accommodations, and great hospitality.
The current kind of wraps back around.
Gotcha.
This is a good one.
Hey?
I think this is a better fish.
Good walleye?
Yeah.
Yeah, decent walleye, yep.
Come here, you.
Mm-hmm. Look at some of the other ones we have for size, for take some pictures, that'll be fine. Okay, you talk about easy fishing. That's why so many people like this resort. You come out like that, even off the dock, in front of the docks, or one of their boats, short pitch. We're sitting in 20 feet of water. Just make sure I got braid to a leader. So make sure it goes straight down. On bottom, open up the bail, bottom, that's where you want to be with these walleyes. Your favorite little rods, and just shake. Just real light little shakes on the bottom, sometimes just dragging it. Little shakes, they'll find it. That little leech or minnow or night crawler kicking on bottom, there's one right there. There's another one. That's a better one. If it's... It is. Yeah, nice. No, it's there. Just...
That's a beauty.
It just felt nice. Eh?
That's a beauty.
Nice gold.
Gold bar.
Yeah.
Gorgeous little fish. Go on. But see that little jig there with the short shank? We're using small minnows and leeches. The shorter shank is the deal for the leeches. A lot shorter profile. That is a fish. Well, better fish too. If it's walleye, it's going to be big.
Yeah, normally the fish here are decent.
If it's walleye, it's going to be big, but I think it's maybe northern. Oh, no, big, nice walleye.
Nice walleye.
Oh, yeah, nice walleye, eh?
Yep. Oof.
In that current tail race. Yes, yes, yes. Look where he's got it too. Look at that, eh? Went to one of my favorite lime chartreuse jigs, and I got it with a traditional 6.5-7 foot spinning rod, 15 pound braid to a fluorocarbon leader, and 3/16 ounce, 1/4 ounce, 1/8 ounce. You can't beat it.
There's one tee. Oh, it doesn't feel bad either. Oh no, it feels pretty good. Did I get pikey? Let's see. Is it ikey or is it big walleye? Oh boy, if it's walleye, it could be very good. I think it's Ike. It is Ike.
Oh, nice walleye.
Oh, walleye, it is too. Nice one.
Yeah.
Yeah, right on. Right on. Walters.
Man, what an experience, you know? caught a bunch of fish on the topwater. Tube jig again provided us some excellent multi-species action. The jigs, you can't go wrong when you're fishing in Northern Ontario. So think about Kashabowie River Resort when you're planning your next vacation. The owners are great, fishing is spectacular, scenery speaks for itself. Thanks for watching. We're gonna see you next time somewhere else in Northern Ontario, catching everything that swims and having the time of our life. So hopefully when you're planning your vacations, think about how each lodge is very unique. Every place has their own attractions, amenities, dinners, cabins, you name it. It's all here waiting for you in Go Fish Ontario. We'll see you next week on Extreme Angler TV. Thanks for watching.